Hello, how are you children? So you might have started with your online virtual classes from your respective schools. I am Neha Talwar. I'll be taking up science and I'll be uploading videos of each and every chapter of science and I'll be covering from class 6th till class 10th. I'll be referring to typical CBSE NCERT curriculum. So you can anytime click to my video and you can have a better understanding for whatever chapter you have been doing in the class by your teacher. So today we'll be starting with class 7, chapter 1, Nutrition in Plants. I'll be giving a brief about the chapter. So number 1 is, you must know what are nutrients. Nutrient is a food that we take in. The food that provides energy that has got all the components that is called a nutrient. And what is nutrition? Nutrition is a mode of taking in food by an organism that is called as nutrition. And the food that we take in our body is used for two processes. Number one, it is used for growth of the body. And number two, it is used for the repair of worn out parts of the body. So this is what is nutrient and what is nutrition. Now since we are taking off nutrition in plants, so you must know there are two modes of nutrition. Number one is, you all know, autotrophic nutrition. Auto means self and nutrition means nourishment. Autotrophic nutrition, that is plants make their own food. And second is heterotrophic nutrition. Hetero means other and trophic means nourishment, that is taking food from other organism, that is called as heterotrophic nutrition. And you'll be surprised to know that plants not only undergo autotrophic nutrition but also undergo heterotrophic nutrition. That is what is being told in class 7. So first and foremost, we'll be taking care of autotrophic nutrition. You know the what is photosynthesis? Photosynthesis is derived from two words. Photo means light and synthesis means to produce. So you all know that green plants make their food in the presence of sunlight, number one, and number two is chlorophyll. So these two are main components which are required for the process to occur, but the reactants are carbon dioxide and water. So what is photosynthesis? It is a process in green plants when carbon dioxide, which plants take from stomata in the air, from the air stomata takes in carbon dioxide, combines with water molecules. Water roots get in water from the soil and they move up through the small tubes, which we'll learn later. So 6 molecules of carbon dioxide combines with 12 molecules of water in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll. This is very important to form glucose. Glucose is C6H12O6 plus 6 molecules of oxygen and 6 molecules of water. So in return, these are called as reactants. These are called as reactants. Reactants. These two which are written on the left side are reactants, and these which are written on the right side, they are called as products or byproducts. So in the process of photosynthesis, reactants are carbon dioxide and water, and byproducts are glucose, oxygen and water. You'll be surprised to know that the oxygen which evolves at the time of photosynthesis does not come from carbon dioxide, but it comes from water molecules. So 6 molecules of carbon dioxide combines with 12 molecules of water to produce glucose, oxygen 6 molecules and water also 6 molecules. So this is the process of photosynthesis by which glucose is being formed. So now, since you are growing up now, you must know what is cell. This is a minor thing. Every human body, every living body, may be plants, animals, human beings, they are all made up of cells. And a simple cell consists of 3 major components. Number 1 is the outer membrane of the cell. This is called as cell membrane. This is called as cell membrane that makes a boundary of a cell and divides and separates it from the outside components. Second is a jelly-like material which is present in the cell. Inside the cell when you enter, there is a jelly-like material and this is called as cytoplasm. This material is called as cytoplasm, and the main component which controls all the activities of the cell, that is called as nucleus. So there are three major components of a cell: cell membrane, cytoplasm and the nucleus. So till now we have done autotrophic, heterotrophic nutrition, what is cell, what is photosynthesis and what is the byproduct of photosynthesis. Now what I will tell you, I will rub this. Since the byproduct is glucose, if you take glucose from the market, you dissolve it in water, what will happen? It will easily get dissolved and it can be transferred to all parts of your body. The same is the case with glucose. If the glucose remains as a product of photosynthesis, it can be easily consumed by the plant. So plant, how will plant give food to us? If plants will consume complete glucose, how will they give food to us? So what is the case is, after photosynthesis, step 1 is glucose will convert to starch, which is stored food material. That is, the food material which is being made by the plant is stored in the form of starch. Starch is a main component of food. Now second is, since you have been told that plants give us proteins, plants give us carbohydrates, fats, minerals and everything. So what happens? Carbon, hydrogen and oxygen are the three main components which are being produced by photosynthesis in the leaf. Where do they form? Leaf. So leaf is also called as food factory of plant. Food factory of plant. So these are the three components which are required to make fat also. Carbohydrates, fats and carbohydrates. But what about proteins? Proteins contain one more important element, that is nitrogen. Nitrogen, plants cannot make nitrogen on their own. So how can you say that plants give us proteins, plants give us nitrogen? There is abundant of nitrogen in the air, there is about 78% of nitrogen, since you might have learned. But that nitrogen plants cannot consume, this is unfortunate part of plant. So what helps the plant to take nitrogen? This is very important, very very important. Since we have, now we know that plants can make us proteins, fats, plants can make us carbohydrates, but for nitrogen, plants have, certain plants in their roots, they have got small nodules. These are small, this is a plant above the soil and these are small nodules. These nodules of certain plants, they have a bacteria by the name of rhizobium. Rhizobium is a nitrogen fixing bacteria. Rhizobium is basically a friend to plant. It is a friend to plant. When it becomes friend to plant, this relationship is called as symbiotic relationship. In symbiotic relationship, both the organism, maybe plant and organism or organism, they are helpful to each other in one or the other form. So what happens? Rhizobium lives in these root nodules. They have a capacity to fix atmospheric nitrogen in the form of nitrates. So they fix atmospheric nitrogen in the form of nitrates, and these nitrates, they get dissolved in water. Here is water in the roots. They get dissolved in water. So these nitrates, they are transferred to upper part of the plant in dissolved form. So plants become rich in nitrogen, so they can form proteins. So these type of plants are not every plant. You cannot say neem can fix nitrogen. You cannot say people can. You cannot say orange can fix nitrogen. So all these plants, all plants are not capable of fixing atmospheric nitrogen. There are certain plants which you might have learned that pulses are rich in proteins. Soya bean is rich in proteins. Chickpeas are rich in proteins. So there are certain plants which have capacity to fix nitrogen. These specific plants are called as leguminous plants. So now the complete concept here is we have got a set category of plants called leguminous plants which have capacity to fix atmospheric nitrogen through root nodules where bacteria by the name of rhizobium lives. And in return, that bacteria takes water and food and shelter from the plant roots. Yes, so both are helpful to each other and both can solve each other's purpose of survival and become more healthy as well. Yeah, so this is how the nitrogen comes into the soil. So now you all know carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen. So example of leguminous plants, you know, chickpeas. What else? Pulses. What else? Lentils, which we call dal. Yeah. So these are all rich in nitrogen. These are all rich in proteins and very good for growth and development of the body. Protein is a main component for all the living organisms, basically for the children as well and sports people also. They must take much and much of proteins in their diet. So this is how, now you are through with everything. So now what next I will cover with you? I will cover, if I say I have got two plants, how can you show me that sunlight is important? I will keep my plant in the dark and I will see if the food is being formed by the plant or not. Yes? You will tell me? Yeah. So let me do this experiment. The experiment which says sunlight is important for plants' growth. So I have got two plants. One is this plant. Other is this plant. So this plant is kept in light and this plant was kept in dark without sunlight for 4 to 5 days. Trial time going on. So now you will come to me, ma'am, how can you say that even it has got green color? It has got green, though its color fades after some time. But yes, they have got green color. How can you say that photosynthesis requires sunlight? So I will conduct one experiment which has got basically 3 steps. I will take leaf of this plant and I will take leaf of this plant. I will say leaf 1, I will say leaf 2. So in first step, I will boil leaves of both the plants separately in a beaker. In a beaker, I will boil both the plants' leaves. First step is boiling leaves of both the plant. What happens after boiling? I told you about the cell structure. So the plants have got one more layer outside the cell membrane, that is a cell wall. So cell, number one, cell membrane breaks. After boiling, cell membrane will break and cell wall will become very, very soft. becomes very, very soft. So if you want to enter anybody's house, first of all, you have to break the main gate. Then the internal gate also, you have to do something so that it becomes soft so that you can penetrate easily. Same is the case here. So the first step, we have broken two doors, we have broken cell membrane, and we have made cell wall very, very soft. Okay. Now the second step. I will take this leaf and I will take this leaf. I will put both the leaves in another solution which is called as methyl alcohol. What is the solution? Methyl alcohol. And what is the function of methyl alcohol? Methyl alcohol will destroy chlorophyll. Whatever chlorophyll is present in the leaf, methyl alcohol will degenerate complete chlorophyll. So it will degenerate chlorophyll. Okay, and now I will write third step here for better visibility. This I took in methyl alcohol here, methyl alcohol here. So now the chlorophyll is being destroyed. Now the third step, let me put this in a boiling water, okay, and then wash it. I will wash it. These leaves are being washed. And last step, fourth step, which is the main step, I will put a drop of starch on both the leaves separately. I'll put this leaf on a petri dish and I'll put drop of starch solution. Iodine solution. I'll put a drop of iodine solution. So what will happen? The main thing is iodine, wherever the starch is present, iodine will turn its color to blue-black. So what will happen? In this leaf, the color, because it was kept in sunlight, so the color of iodine will change to blue-black. But here, no change in color, because no starch is there. So this is a test which is mandatory, that sunlight is required for photosynthesis. The test took place in four steps. Number one, we took leaf from both the plants. One plant was kept in dark for some time, 4-5 days. Other plant was in light. We took the leaf. We start boiling the leaf. Why? To break the walls. Number one, it could break cell membrane. Then cell wall becomes very, very soft so that iodine solution which you have put later can easily penetrate. Even methyl alcohol which you have put so that it can easily penetrate. So next step is we will put methyl alcohol in the both the leaves which were kept in the boiling water. So what will happen? It will degenerate the chlorophyll from the leaf. And then the last step, which is the main step, is that is on both the leaves we will put iodine solution. So what happens with the iodine? The color wherever the starch is present will change to blue-black. But there is no change in blue-black color when the leaf which was not kept in sunlight. So this is how you can test the presence of starch and if sunlight is important for photosynthesis. So now we have covered this topic as well. I think it would gave you better understanding and you could understand the whole concept. So if you have any doubt for whatever I have taught, the complete chapter is not possible in one day, and even you will feel that the chapter becomes boring, which I really don't want that. Let the interest continues and let the suspense also continues. Let me see how can we will see how plants can be heterotrophic. We have seen plants autotrophic. छोटे होते से पढ़ते आए हैं ना कि बच्चों प्लांट्स अपना फूड खुद बनाते हैं बट यहाँ पे व्हाट विल वी स्टडी दैट प्लांट्स नॉट ओनली कैन मेक देयर फूड बट देयर आर सम प्लांट्स हु आर इनकैपेबल ऑफ मेकिंग फूड सो दे डिपेंड ऑन अदर प्लांट्स और लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म एज वेल for food. This topic we will cover later, and also we will cover another topic, that is stomata. These two topics which are being left, that is, what is stomata, how does it open, how does it close, how the gaseous exchange takes place, where is the stomata in cascata, do you find stomata in desserts, leaves of the desert plant. So there are many things which will come to your mind. So if you have any doubt, any query to whatever I have taught you in the class today, please write me on my email address and please put your phone number as well. I will get back to you. My email address is nehatalwar07@gmail.com. And please subscribe my channel to get regular updates for whatever chapters I'll be uploading, for whatever tests I'll be uploading. And if you have any query, anything, please do come back to me through my email address and I will directly get in touch with you by the phone number which you'll be mentioning on your email. Thank you so much. I repeat my email address, nehatalwar07@gmail.com. Good luck and have a great start of the year, children. I want you to shine this year. Bye.